Imagine what it would be like 150 years ago to be, let's say, 10 years old and living in this area. Of course, the area at the time was called Boone, Maryland, not Severna Park. The Civil War was over, and you had several brothers and sisters, but for one reason or the other, you wanted to get an education. Now, the orange school bus 150 years ago didn't come by to pick you up. You had to get to school one way or the other. And in many cases, you had to walk. It may be a mile, it may be 5 miles. Now, there was a train that ran down through the middle of Boone, Maryland, that connected Baltimore and Washington. Possibly you could have picked up on the train, but your family didn't have very much money either. So probably walking's it. Maybe there's an old horse you could use, but you had to get to school the best way you could. And you came to school in Boone in a little one-room schoolhouse. A half acre was donated by a fellow by the name of James Stallings to build the school. Of course, there was no electricity. There was no light. There was no water. It was a one-room schoolhouse that had a potbelly stove in the middle of the room. And the teacher's responsibility was not only teaching the kids, but she also had to start, or he had to start as well, had to start the fire going in the morning. Was probably too a counselor, a doctor. Teachers had to do everything, and they couldn't be married. The requirements were pretty stringent on what they could be or how they lived, because they had to set a good example for all those kids. Now, Severna Park, a few years later, started to grow a little bit. And in 1906, a fellow by the name of Oscar Hatton from Baltimore, a lawyer, came down and he bought what's known now as Old Severna Park. He developed it. He put in the roads, he put in the water, he put in the electricity, he put in the telephone, and he also gave the school, Severna Park Elementary School, more property. So they were able to have now a modern two-room classroom. Now they have two teachers that are there. The school went from first grade to eighth grade. And at that particular time, they had two outhouses in the back, one for the girls and one for the boys. And in the morning when the teacher came in, she would select two students to run down to Gorsuch's store down on 4 Riggs Avenue here in Severna Park to get up 2 buckets of water in these wooden buckets and carry them back. It was always a kind of a treat to be able to do that. It was kind of like when your teacher said to you, would you clean the blackboard erasers for you, where you go outside and kind of smack them together. So it was kind of a privileged thing. They'd bring those buckets back. One bucket was for washing, and everybody washed out of that bucket. And one bucket was for drinking. It had a little tin cup or a ladle on the side, and everybody, including the teacher, drank out of that bucket. Now imagine if somebody has a sore throat or a cold, everybody's gonna have to come down with the whole thing. Well, a few years later, they put another addition on, so now it has 3 rooms. And 2 ladies from down in Annapolis, one was Margaret Moss. She had just graduated from Annapolis Senior High School. She came down to be a teacher. And another gal by the name of Lucy Walker came down. She eventually married a fellow by the name of Landers, Stuart Landers, who was a student over at Severn School. And both of those ladies were there for 50 years. I'll talk about them a little bit later. So the school started to grow, and it started to get more students. And eventually they realized, we have over 100 students. Now in the beginning, they may have 22 students that are signed up, but only 10 of them show up every day because it was a big deal to come to school. So they said in about 1938, well, this is time for us to build a new building. So they built a 4-room brick building that basically is still on the site there in Severna Park. A few years later, they added 2 more rooms. In the late 40s, early 50s, they added 4 rooms and a cafeteria. That's when I went in 1949. I'm not that old. At any rate, so I went through there till the fifth grade. Both of my sons went there as well. The school was very nurturing. We did have electricity. We did have bathrooms at that particular time. The school has expanded now, and it's very modern. The parents are very, very active in the school, turning out some wonderful kids that are going to the Severna Park Middle School or to the brand new Severna Park High School. I was fortunate enough to go to Severna Park High School when it opened in 1959, but unfortunately, last year they tore it down. So go back to the teachers for a few minutes. Miss Moss was the principal. She had started in 1919. She was about 5 feet tall, kind of, you didn't want to mess with her too much. And the worst thing she could say is, "Scott, go home and come back with your mother." That wasn't a good thing. But at any rate, she had these little stacked heels and she had silver bracelets on her wrist. And you could hear her jingle jangling and thumping coming down the hall. And you certainly minded your P's and Q's at that time. Miss Landers was probably one of the best teachers that was ever there. Everybody wanted to have first grade with Miss Landers. She taught everybody how to read. She was also nurturing. She was a wonderful teacher. One of my favorites was a gal by the name of Miss Dill. Now, she's still around. I see her down at Adam's Ribs from time to time. And she'd play softball. She'd play right there with you. She'd hit the ball right and everything. She was really great. There are other teachers. There was one called Miss Bowen. Miss Bigby was my second and third grade teacher. She was big into music. So I think we're very fortunate to have a wonderful little school like Severna Park Elementary School. And it continues to produce great little students. Thank you.